tropical. Well, hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's Richard here, and this afternoon I'm going to put out a video that I did about 2 weeks ago, and it's all about the new project of mine, which is the Technics SC-HD550, which is a small MIDI system that I think probably came out in the late 80s, maybe a bit later than that. I can't actually find a date on the internet to let, so I can't really, but somebody out there might already have one of these systems. It's an amazing sound, and so I'm going to showcase that to you. And I bought it from a local charity shop, Demelza House, which is in Maidstone, and they do some amazing work looking after children with life-limiting conditions, so I'm always happy to support them. So I'll let the video do its speaking, but also I thought I'd end the video with a couple of very nice Columbia records from the collection that I found recently. I don't think I've played these before. This is the Time Will Tell by Jack Payne and the BBC Dance Orchestra, this one here. It's in quite good condition, nice. Yes, and I'll put some photographs on there. The B-side is When It's Night Time in Nevada, which is quite famous, so I've heard that before on some of the other records, again by Jack Payne, and it's a 40 tempo. So yeah, very nice there. So I hope you enjoy that. It's in this wonderful cover by Valance's, Yorkshire's Centre for Record Enthusiasts, Harrow House, Leeds. So if anyone is from that part of the country, then you might recognise this. It's actually got a telephone number on here as well. At that time it had three lines in. Amazing mover. Yeah, so it's been quite busy work-wise with job two as well as job one. But this is bank holiday that we've just had. I've just been all the way to Worthing and stayed at the Worthing Rugby Club and did some amazing hiking around Worthing along the South Downs National Park, and visited the Langham Brewery there, and we had some very nice beer, I have to say, and some pizza, and also did a pub crawl. It was supposed to be, it was hiking really, it was about three pubs we visited around the area too, so I did a complete circle. So I must have done at least 15 and a half miles in walking time. Lovely area. The weather was absolutely superb, really was, and thoroughly enjoyed myself. Feeling quite relaxed at the moment and going back to work tomorrow, so I hope I'm going to be all right with that. But anyway, less waffle. Thank you for subscribing to the channel, and if you're new, welcome. And so we had over 83 likes or views on the last one, the Festival Italia that I did. Hope everyone enjoyed that. And more coming on this channel soon. And keep safe, stay soon, and see you very soon. Take care, bye for now. Well, hello everybody, it's Richard here, and it's been absolutely ages since I last uploaded a video. So this afternoon I thought I'd sort of grasp the nettle, and because I've been doing some project work, and I'm going to talk about this very nice machine in front of me as well. So sorry that I have been around. I know that some people have been commenting that was I all right? Yeah, I'm okay. I've just been very, very busy with my two jobs, my consultancy work and also my job at the Heart Again Hospice. So it's been a really busy time. And so this afternoon, though it's Tuesday today, I decided that I hadn't got anything booked in, no Zoom calls, nothing like that. So I thought, and the weather is a bit better today, though we've had a lot of rain, I thought perhaps I'd just come and chat to you. So this video will be part of a series of other records I'm going to play as well. So hold fire. And thank you everyone who commented on the last video upload back in June. I was over, I think it was 82 views to date, which is quite nice. So this is the, this machine is the Technics SC-HD550, and I've been doing some research. I'm not sure when this came out, this machine, as it's got a cassette deck which I've just serviced, and a CD player which has also been serviced, and the rest of it. I assume that probably it's late 90s, might be, you know, middle 90s probably. But what I like about this machine is that it's got an amazing sound. It's also got a bi-wire speaker system, and that means that instead of having a crossover in the speakers in here, in each speaker box, it actually does that through the amplifier. It's 25 watts per channel, so it's a 50 watt system, though it says 70 on there, but I don't believe that. I've done some research and it definitely says 25. You can get this the manual for this machine on the internet, which is what I've looked at, so I knew exactly what I was dealing with. I've had it all apart, and I've left the cassette deck top off as well, because it comes with, it comes with these lovely wood type ends. These aren't real wood, of course, they're plastic, but they remind me of some of the cars that used to have this fake wood trim in them. But it looks really nice. The speakers, they're not solid wood, they're sort of fiberboard, and in fact, if you look up there, you'll see one of the similar ones that I got with another system. And then when I had the flood, if people remember that far back, the flood I had, when all the water came in through the ceiling, then they unfortunately got very damp, and then when they dried out, we ended up with a warped speaker case. But anyway, they still work otherwise. So yeah, so this is one of those ribbon wire systems, and I'll show you that if I remember to do that. I've got this very nice new stand as well. Look, I can move around. It's, you know, on a tripod. I got this for £5 from the local charity shop, and it's really substantial. It goes up and down. I've got a second one in the office, which you have seen, because I've used that, along with the microphone extensions and that. So we're getting very whizzy now. Anyway, that's about that. So I really like this machine, and it's so I got it from the Demelza House charity shop. I paid a bit for it, which was more than I intended to, but it's very, very nice. And I think it's been well looked after. It came with all the cables and everything in a bag. So clearly somebody had cared for this. And so, yeah, I'm thinking of putting this in the main house, because some of you may remember that I had a Sony system where I was trying to get the cassette deck to work, and it never did. And somebody very kindly offered to take it from me and fix it, but it would have cost so much that in the end I scrapped it and just kept the amplifier and the CD player. The tuner, I've got a Pioneer tuner which I'm using with it at the moment. But this Technics equipment is very nice. I mean, I've got lots of Technics that I use, and it really is the sort of bee's knees in my view, this particular stuff. And so it's got a really well built amplifier. It comes apart really easily, it connects very easily. So, and I just love the design of this sort of design that looks like separates, but in fact they're not, they're just ribboned together. But hey ho, you know, it works well. So I'm gonna switch it on a second and then demonstrate it to you, so stay tuned for that. I've got some photographs which I'll insert as well as we go along. So the first thing you need to do is that the switch on button is here. There we go. And then it comes up with hello on here. You might be able to see that. So the radio. So this is like a, what do you call it, input selector, but it's like a jog. So at the moment it's on CD. If I move it, that's extension which you can play a record deck through, but you need I think I'm going to need a preamp for that, because it won't work with the cartridge I've got on there. Right, this is the tuner, and it does it in decibels, which is interesting. It's stereo. This is a classic FM, so. And I just love the way it operates. You've got treble and bass here, and then for example, treble comes up +6, and you can run it down to, you can see that, down to 2. And then the bass is the same. Minus it 2. This is really nice. I think it's got a really nice sound. It's
tend to want it on 6, but it might hit, maybe my ears. So if we take it over to, it comes up this little light as well, of this here, which is VGCA, variable something or other it says on there. Oh, variable gain, that's what it says on there. So yeah, so it's really nice. And then you've got this wide version as well, which I think sounds better off, but there we are, maybe just me with it sitting in here on the bench. So if we put it onto tape, if I then the tape deck is really something to, it's very much similar to, the Carpenters are going to play short, it's Karen Carpenter we're playing here. The tape deck is very similar to the cassette deck. So if you open this one, oh, it's not on the cassette, you had to put it onto there, but it opens the same way, which means that the, and I'm going to show you this in operation in a second, I'll take it off the stand to do that, the camera that is. It operates in that it flips the head over to play the second side, so the cassette doesn't need to be flipped over, which is quite a nice little touch, really, I think, for a system like this. Obviously, they were trying to emulate CDs. I'm going to play you some Craig David. Sorry if nobody likes Craig David, but I think he's a really nice guy and really sings well. It's one of his earlier ones. And this is a CDR that I did many years ago when I had CDs in my car before I had an iPod. So Craig's going to sing for us in a minute. But I'll just play this. This is Karen Carpenter. So you've got all these buttons on here. So you've got Dolby noise reduction, tape skip, counter, reset, and our rev mode. I've not used these yet, but what we'll do is, and then you've got record pause, so you can record on this as well. So there's a head that switches over. So if I just put this in, and then if we, I think, well, just see what side we're on, excuse me a second. So this is side 2. So we go to side 1, which is what you'd normally put it on. You see the motor winds it in. You can still get the belts for these, I've checked, and the belt in this one is really good. So it's no, it hasn't got that memory belt stuff that you sometimes get scared, and it hasn't gone to mush, thank God. And all the cogs and that are really nice. It's really well made. You can just take it out. The whole system comes out by a couple of screws. I'm going to rewind this. Oops, sorry, a second. Let's rewind it first. You can hear the motor whirling away there. We'll just let Karen roll back. So this is the Carpenters Only Yesterday. You might be able to see that. That's it. Really good. So you can see the tape counter down here. You can see that. This machine, this bit, is just for display purposes, and also the radio, which is quite good. So I quite like the design of it. I think it really looks nice. And of course, this silver stuff is gone out of fashion now. It's all black. So I think with the speakers, and also they come with these covers. The covers here as well, which are quite nice. So I'll clean those up. They were a bit dusty. Right, let's play this and see what it sounds like. Right, it's going to play the other side. So it's obviously going from left to right, but it does that automatically. You can see the numbers down here, which I imagine you can reset. Okay.
When I was young, I'd listen to the radio, waiting for my favorite songs. When they played, I'd sing along. It made me smile. Those were such happy times, and not so long. Gone, but they're back again.
got a really deep bass. For 50 watts, that would definitely fill a room. Turn it down a bit. I mean, certainly, certainly the those other speakers that are in the corner that you could see there, I'm just holding the microphone so I can know, they really sound nice. They've got a rich, nice, really deep sound. So yeah, so I've cleaned it all up inside, dusted it all. There wasn't much dust in there. The cassette deck definitely needed a service, got lots of muck off the sprockets. There's like two sprockets, so it switches over. So if you're halfway through, say this song, and then you want to go the other way, there you go. You don't actually have to stop it to do that. Isn't Karen amazing? You can just adjust the treble and bass. And you've got the wide version. I think it sounds better without, personally. You've got Dolby. That's Dolby. Dolby off. Not sure what that does. Let's reset. So that's the cassette, and I thought perhaps I'll show you how the cassette works once we play the CD player. So let's turn this down. So let's turn this off, and that's, and it really, it's got a real sort of click to it when it does that. So if I now move it on to the, where are we? That's tuner again. Okay, let's see. Oh, I know why, because I haven't... okay, we're going to stop the camera a minute and I'll plug the CD player in. Hold with me. Right, okay, we're back again. So I hadn't plugged in the ribbon at the back, so we've got the disc here. So this with the CD player, we can open the drawer. There we go. And it's a really quiet system, says he, dropping Craig David on the floor. One minute. This is totally off the cuff. Right, so this is a CDR that I recorded a while ago. As I say, I used to have it in the car. So let's plug that in. There we go. Really quiet system. This is from the album Slicker Than the Average. There wasn't anything to... I cleaned the lens off and cleaned all the mechanism there. There wasn't anything that I had to worry about here. You can get the styluses for these. I've seen a chap on YouTube I watched earlier today, and he got... his wasn't working, but he got a new piece. It's really nice. Anyway, so that's that one. Okay, so that's that. So we'll take Craig out again. Really quiet draw. I think you have to have it in this order, by the way. You can't change the order in which the units are because of the way the size of the ribbon at the back. So let me just stop the camera a second and I'll come back to you. So we're back again. So right, okay, so I've taken you off the stand. By the way, this is the really nice aluminium stand I'm now using for the GoPro. I've got the connection out here. I've got a couple of these. That's good. So yeah, so it's really steady and it's really good in here because I can then, when I play music for you, I can 78s or whatever, I can put that on there. So right, so this is, let me just show you the mechanism working. So you can see here, if I find a pointer. So you've got the cassettes in here. So if we take the, there we go. There's the cassette coming out. And then at the back here, you've got these, obviously it's like a double cassette, but it's in one. So you've got the head here, which flips up and down, and I'll show you that in a moment. And then you've got these lovely pinch rollers there, and then the sprockets. The belts and the motor are underneath there. So it's very much like a CD transport system, if that's the right word to use. As in that it, how it operates. So if I put this, so put this in again. Okay, so you see that? Hang it back again. Okay, and if I press play, you'll see how it goes. Now if I turn it over, you can see the cassette going round there. So if I press the other way, there you go, almost missed it, the head flips over, so I'll do it again, there you go, and then if you go, there you go, and then if you can stop it and go fast forward, normal tape function, and then the other way. So there we go. So I think it's an amazing bit of kit, really. I quite easily have it out here, and I'll show you around the back in a second. But the speakers are really nice. You've got the and then at the back, behind the speakers, if I turn this round, you've got the low frequency and high frequency. So it's like each speaker within the cabinet is separated. There's no crossing over. And then they fit, go back to the... which is something I didn't realise. I'd never seen this sort of thing before. Obviously, the Japanese were quite keen in getting this done. I'll turn it round, you can see then the other side of that. So hang, stay with me. Just stay with me a sec. So you're back with me again. So the ribbon, this is a ribbon strip here, and this connects everything. So you've got the amplifier at the bottom, and then obviously you've got the tuner, which is a shorter one, and then obviously the cassette deck, and then the CD player fits on top. So then it reconnects with this piece here onto the back of here. So there we go. So yeah, so it's a really nice system. And it's lovely wood grain stuff. It reminds me of, I say, one of the sort of 90s cars really that used to come along with that when it was, you know, remind me of Rover 75s or something that used to have that sort of wood grain stuff in them. But I think it's a really nice system. I don't know what you think. I'd be interested to see what you think. And what I'm going to try and do is link it up to the dual, see whether I can get to work with a preamp. It might do, because it's certainly not working otherwise, though it says on the instructions it will work with a record player, but I've not, I think the EXT one, I may be not working, or it may be just me. Anyway, thanks for that, and I'll be back soon. So I've got this now, the Technics machine rigged up to the record deck. My dual doesn't seem to want to work. I don't know, the motors, I've changed the fuse, it's not working. Anyway, I've put back in the Garrard that I was playing with in some videos back, and one of my favourite records, as you're probably aware, is that I love Ivor Novello. So this is with Vanessa Lee, and it's amazing. This is from Glamorous Nights, and so the first track, and so I'm going to play that to you through this system. And I've had to use I've put a preamp on here. You can see that there on top of the unit. One of these preamps. I've used that quite a few times before when you need a bit of a boost, because clearly this machine's not set up with a built-in preamp. So on that basis. So yeah. So let's hear what this really sounds like, and enjoy the track. There is a slight hum because I've not grounded it, but it doesn't come over too bad anyway. So anyway, see what you think. And here we go. So this is Vanessa Lee singing on the Ivor Novello record, a beautiful record from the 60s, late 50s, and Glamorous Nights. Here we go. Full stops. I was actually touching the wrong controller, so I switched the radio back on. Hang on a second, we'll start again. You don't get songs like that. I really miss Ivor Novello. I wish that you know, the theatre world would bring him back, because some of the music he produced just is a tingling moment for me. And I hope you enjoyed that as a demonstration of this. We're using the SP 25 Mark III, yeah, it's a really, as you know, we refurbished that machine some time ago, and I hope you enjoyed that. So yes, so for this part of the video, that's it, and I'll be back shortly.
On Columbia, Time Will Tell Foxtrot, the BBC Dance Orchestra with Jack Payne, with vocal chorus by Jack Payne. This is on the Columbia CB348. Enjoy. Think that Jack Payne and the BBC Dance Orchestra really have a great presence for the records of that particular era of the 30s. So I'm going to play the second side of this, and this time it's When It's Night Time in Nevada. It's a waltz, this one, again by Jack Payne and the chorus on Columbia CB348. So enjoy. Thank you.
in Nevada I'm dreaming of the old days on the prairie and you. I miss you when the campfire is gleaming, and I wonder if you miss me too. I can see the great divide and the trail we used to ride, the only bit of heaven I knew. When it's night, I'm in Nevada, I'm dreaming of the old days on the prairie and you.
That was Jack Payne, and great number there. Hope you enjoy that.
In tropical climes, there are certain times of day when all the citizens retire to take their clothes off and perspire. It's one of those rules the greatest fools obey.